Let's watch. Edward Snowden is a man without a country. Good evening, I'm Lori Johnson. The NSA leaker is on the run, looking for political asylum. He's been hopscotching around the globe and is rumored to be seeking refuge in Ecuador. Meanwhile, U.S. officials are scrambling to stop Snowden before more top secret information is released. Heather Sells reports.
Edward Snowden continues to evade the normally long arm of U.S. justice. Over the weekend, the U.S. asked Hong Kong to arrest him and begin the extradition process. But Hong Kong officials said there were problems with the legal documents and allowed Snowden to leave for Russia despite having had his passport revoked.
What's infuriating here is Prime Minister Putin of Russia aiding and abetting Snowden's escape. The bottom line is very simple. Allies are supposed to treat each other in decent ways, and Putin always seems almost eager to put a finger in the eye of the United States, whether it is Syria, Iran, and now, of course, with Snowden. That's not how allies should treat one another, and I think it'll have serious consequences for the United States-Russia relationship.
A spokesman for Putin said Snowden's arrival in Russia was unexpected. The U.S. demanded Russia expel the fugitive and warned other countries not to let him through.
What Snowden has revealed has caused irreversible and significant damage to our country and to our allies. This is an individual who is not acting, in my opinion, with noble intent.
Snowden was expected to leave Russia today, flying first to Cuba and then on to Ecuador, where officials say they're considering his request for asylum. But this morning, Snowden was a no-show at the airport, missing his flight to Cuba.
We don't know specifically where he may head or what his intended destination may be. He places himself above the law, and I think there are very serious implications in that.
Today, there's growing concern that the former NSA contractor will publicly reveal more damaging information or even pass it on to America's rivals. Senator Dianne Feinstein, the chair of the Senate Intelligence Committee, said on CBS's Face the Nation that Snowden has perhaps more than 200 sensitive documents. And Snowden himself says he's traveling with numerous American intelligence secrets.
I had access to, you know, the full rosters of everyone working at the NSA, the entire intelligence community, and undercover assets all around the world.
Heather Sells, CBN News.